Myself Vikas Tanjan for chapter number 4, quadratic equation. This is the part 2. In this part, we will learn about the nature of roots. In the previous section, we have discussed that how to find the roots of quadratic equation. So, roots of quadratic equation is given by x equals to minus b plus minus root b square minus 4ac upon 2a. So this is the formula in which x equals to minus b plus minus root b square minus 4ac upon 2a. So we can find the roots of given quadratic equation. ax square plus bx plus c equals to 0 form. So let's see nature of roots. Nature of roots means the roots will be real or not. It means we will check that the given roots of the quadratic equation are real or not. First case, case 1, if b square minus 4ac greater than 0 means positive. If b square minus 4ac is positive number, then x equals to minus b upon 2a plus root b square minus 4ac upon 2a. First root, another root x equals to minus b upon 2a, this time minus root b square minus 4ac upon 2a. So they are two distinct real roots. If b square minus 4ac greater than 0. So in case 1, if b square minus 4ac is positive, so we can find the square root of positive number easily. So we can find the roots will be two distinct real roots. Real means real number. Okay. Now case 2, if b square minus 4ac equals to 0. If b square minus 4ac equals to 0 in this formula, then x equals to minus b upon 2a plus minus root 0, which will be minus b upon 2a. So both the roots will be same, which will be x equals to minus b upon 2a. So the roots will be equal. So the roots will be equal if b square minus 4ac equals to 0. Because there will be no meaning of plus minus, it will be 0, it will be cancelled out. So the roots will be same. X equals to minus b upon 2a minus b upon 2a. So in this condition, the roots will be equal. Two roots will be equal. So these were two cases. Now we will talk about third case. So when you calculate b square minus 4ac, b square minus 4ac may be negative, less than 0. Less than 0 means negative. If we calculate b square minus 4ac, it may be positive number, it may be equals to 0, it may be negative. So if b square minus 4ac is negative, then there is no number whose square is negative number. It means we know that there is no number whose square is negative number. So the square root of negative number is not real number. So because of that reason, there will be no real roots. So in this condition, b square minus 4ac will be negative number. So square root of negative number is not possible. Is not possible means it will not be a real number. So we cannot calculate the value in this formula. So we will write there will be no real roots. So we have discussed here three conditions. Case 1, if b square minus 4ac greater than 0, then there will be two distinct real roots. If b square minus 4ac equals to 0, then there will be two equal roots. If b square minus 4ac less than 0, then there will be no real roots. Let's take some example. x square minus 6x plus 3 equals to 0. This is a quadratic equation. So first of all, we want to find the nature of roots. It means we want to find that the roots will be real or not. So first of all, we will find d equals to b square minus 4ac. Here d is called discriminant, which we know already. So let's first calculate a, b, c. A is here 2, B is here minus 6, C is here 3. Okay, so now we will calculate D, B square. B square means minus 6 whole square minus 4 A, A is equals to 2, C is equals to 3. 6 square 36 minus 4 2 is 8, 8 3 is 24. So it will be 12. So D will be 12. So it is a positive number, d greater than 0. So there will be two distinct real roots. There will be two distinct real roots. So let's find x equals to minus b minus 6 plus minus root b square minus 4ac, which we have calculated 12 upon 2 into a 2. So x equals to minus minus plus 6 plus minus root 12 upon 4. So x will be, we can write here 6 plus minus 12 can be written as 4 3 ja, so 2 root 3 upon 4. So take 2 common, 3 plus minus root 3 upon 4, cancel out. So x equals to 3 plus minus root 3 upon 2. So one time is plus and one time is minus, 3 minus root 3 upon 2. So you can see here b square minus 4ac, d is greater than 0. So we find here two distinct real roots. Let's take another example. Two x square minus 3x plus 5 is equals to 0. Let's find d equals to b square minus 4ac. First we find A, B, C. A is 2, B is minus 3, C is 5. D is equals to minus 3 whole square minus 4 into A into C. Minus 3 square 9, 4 2 ja 8, 8 5 ja 40. So it will be minus 31. So you can see D is less than 0. So there will be no real roots. So there will be no real roots because D is negative. Let's take one more example. Three x square minus 4 root 3 x plus 4 equals to 0. So first of all we find D is equals to B square minus 4 AC. A, B, C. A is 3, B is minus 4 root 3 and C is 4. So D equals to B square minus 4 AC. 4, 4 ja 16, 16, 3 ja 48. Minus 4, 4 ja 16, 16, 3 ja 48. So you can see D equals to 48 minus 48, 0. So D equals to 0. So there will be 2 equal roots. There will be 2 equal roots. Okay, so we will calculate the roots of this quadratic equation. So x equals to minus b, b is minus 4 root 3 plus minus root b square minus 4 ac already 0. So we write here 0 upon 2a, a is 3. Okay, so minus minus plus 4 root 3 upon 2, 3 ja 6. So it will be 2 root 3 upon 3. So you can see here x equals to 2 root 3 upon 3, and so x equals to another root will be 2 root 3 upon 3. So the roots are same because this plus minus cancel out because of 0. So I think you have understood the nature of roots. There are three types of basically nature of roots. D square minus 4 ac equals to 0, then there will be equal roots. If b square minus 4 ac greater than 0, then there will be two distinct real roots. If b square minus 4 ac less than 0, then there will be no real roots. Okay, so thank you.